Well, we welcome everyone this morning.
All right.
Get a sound check.
Sounding good.
Okay. This is our first Sunday of 2021, beginning of a new year, and great things that God has prepared in advance for us to walk in them. How exciting. What could be better than a life prepared by God? And a glorious day, beautiful day. So we have lots to pray for this morning, and I have quite a few announcements. So if you are a member of this church, you should already have received via email documents, our constitution and bylaws with suggested revisions. We're still having ongoing discussions about the name. So we have an elders meeting, joint elders meeting this afternoon, after church service today, and see if we can nail that down a little bit better. But it's still a work in progress. And the other announcements are, we hope to be able to resume Bible study on Thursday of this coming week. I will call Tim Holscher and see if he wants to come back and begin in this worship center here on Thursday at 6:30 p.m. and let everybody know what he's decided. Friday, men's prayer has moved back to 5:30 a.m. So take note of that. So those of you who come in prayer. On the 10th, which is next Sunday, we have a special business meeting for Saddle Mountain Bible Church. And in that, we will have discussion on those documents that you have. And any of those of you who are not members who would like to come as observers, you're welcome to do that. If you'd like the documents, I can print them and give them to you as well. So on that 10th, we will be discussing the name and the changes in the documents. And then on the 24th, we have the scheduled annual general meeting. We will soon be passing out elders' evaluations for members to fill out, our annual review of your two elders. So I don't have them with me this morning, but I will have them by next Sunday. What else do we have? The annual general meeting on the 24th, and then in February, on the 21st of February, there is a scheduled joint meeting with Jesus Salvo after we become one to receive all the additional members of their congregation. So that's an important meeting as well. So those are the dates. And if it's not clear, just ask me again, and I will try to make it clear to you.
Good morning. And we've lost the cover. And Billy and Ginger, I want to reach out to you because we need to figure out how you want to be involved in these in the meetings that are coming up. Just stay tuned after service. I want to see how we're gonna bring you into these meetings. If you're either gonna be able to come or be able to join us with Zoom somehow. Just a whole load of COVID and elderly prayer requests and all. And Lord, we just thank you and praise you this morning for all the good work here in Mattawa, Lord, of combining of the congregations here. Lord, we just pray for each one of the steps, and Lord, help us to be able to work together as your body, Lord, that we can get past all the barriers of language and culture and things that divide us, Lord, and we can figure out how we can use those to your strength and to our strengths to really reach out in this community and have a major impact for you in Mattawa. Lord, we lift up the rest of this service, Lord. We just thank you for the words we are about to hear out of Philippians, Lord, and we just give us open ears and an open heart and an open mind to hear your word and to do your will. These things we lift up in Jesus' name. Amen.
Our call to worship this morning comes from the book of Revelation. Revelation chapter 4, verses 1 to 11. It says, "After this I looked, and behold, a door standing open in heaven. And the first voice which I heard speaking to me like a trumpet said, 'Come up here, and I will show you what must take place after this.' At once I was in the Spirit, and behold, a throne stood in heaven, and with one seated on the throne. And he who was seated there had the appearance of jasper and carnelian, and around the throne was a rainbow that had the appearance of an emerald. Around the throne were 24 elders, and seated on the thrones were 24 elders clothed in white garments and with golden crowns on their heads. From the throne came flashes of lightning and rumblings and peals of thunder. And before the throne came burning seven torches of fire, which are the seven spirits of God. And before the throne there was, as it were, a sea of glass like crystal. And around the throne, on each side of the throne, are four living creatures full of eyes in front and behind. The first living creature like a lion, the second living creature like an ox, the third living creature with the face of a man, and the fourth living creature like an eagle in flight. And the four living creatures, each of them with six wings, are full of eyes all around and within. And day and night they never cease to say, 'Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come.' And whenever the living creatures give glory and honor and thanks to him who is seated on the throne, who lives forever and ever, the 24 elders fall down before him who is seated on the throne and worship him who lives forever and ever. They cast their crowns before the throne, saying, 'Worthy are you, O our Lord and God, to receive glory and honor and power, for you created all things, and by your will they existed and were created.'" Let's stand and worship together in our first song and join the heavenly choirs that are singing, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who is and who was and is to come."
In the morning, our song.
Our second song is Come People of the Risen King. And to introduce it, I'm reading from 2 Timothy 2:8 to 13. Remember Jesus Christ, risen from the dead, the offspring of David, as preached in my gospel, for which I am suffering, bound with chains as like a criminal. But the word of God is not bound. Therefore I endure everything for the sake of the elect, that they also may obtain the salvation that is in Christ Jesus with eternal glory. The saying is trustworthy. For if we died with him, we shall also live with him. If we endured, we will also reign with him. If we deny him, he also will deny us. If we are faithless, he remains faithful, for he cannot deny himself. Let's sing together from Come People of the Risen King. Our third song this morning is We Bow Down. It carries the idea of coming into the presence of the Almighty. In Psalms 95, 6, and 7, O come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Let's bow our hearts and worship this morning as we sing, We Bow Down. Our final song this morning is Prince of Peace. Now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling and present you blameless before his presence of his glory with great joy, the only God, our Savior, through Jesus Christ our Lord, be glory and majesty and dominion and authority before all time and now and forever. Amen. Go in peace.